You're listening to 94XO.
94XO Podcast. This is Moni XO. I have promoter, producer, host, and now artist Gusto in the building. What's up?
How you doing?
I'm good. How you doing?
I'm good. And it's Gusto. Gusto Diddy.
Gusto Diddy. Less. Okay, first off, what happened to just Gusto? Where'd Gusto Diddy come from?
Well, first of all, me and Diddy got the same birthday. So it's like, all right, I'll finish this. First of all, I just felt like I do everything in St. Louis, so I was promoting, hosting. Like you said, I do everything, so I'm like, it makes sense. And this girl just randomly told me one day, she was like, you and Diddy just give me the same vibes. It was his birthday. I literally looked it up, it was the same day. Ever since, I was Gusto Diddy.
Okay, so you changed your name. How has your energy been when it comes to promoting events and all that?
I mean,
like, you feel more confident now?
It's been the same. I've always been confident.
Okay, so tell me about, you just dropped a single. It's called Club Banga. So from going from promoting and hosting and stuff, like, what made you want to get into actually dropping a song?
All right, so actually, me and Ashley Booker was working on a production called Return to the City. He was executive producing the project for all the artists in St. Louis. He was like, you turn up all these artists, why don't you just put some out for yourself and see what we can do? It was really just promotion for our project and my parties.
Okay.
And then the song kind of like blew up, so.
So when you wrote the song, like, you actually wrote it out, or was
no,
it like
I was
a
literally like, I was going to the movies to go see a Spider-Man movie, and I came by here to get the beat. And he was like, literally 5 minutes later, I called him like, bro, I literally know what I'm going to say on this hook. So it was from the time I drove from here to the AMC 16, like 5 minutes away. I was like, I know what I'm going to say.
Oh, that's crazy. So how did the collaboration between you and Jonesboy happen with the track?
So honestly, right before we came up with that song, we had Jonesboy in here to work on a whole another song that we was going to try to put a whole
different artist on. Oh, so you tried to kill two birds with one
stone. Yeah, so then it was like, wait, you just killed that last record we just did. Why don't you hop on this? I just had an open record, and I didn't know what to do with it. So I'm like, why don't you hop on this? And then he killed it. So I'm like, hey, let's shoot a video.
And then, like, just seeing, like, on social media, like, how many cities you have the track on with all the DJs. Like, how does that work? Because I don't know, like, behind the scenes. Like, how does it work with you talking to all these different DJs and getting your music played in the different cities?
Well, so I already had a relationship with a lot of DJs and stuff from just the promotions. Mm-hmm. And I also just promote people events that has nothing to do with me. So now that I became an artist and I just reach out to them, they feel, you know what I'm saying, like, okay, I can help him out. He did all this work for me. But honestly, it's a lot going on with that song, so yeah.
Well, what does that mean?
It's kind of like more turned up. it's just kind of blew up.
Mm-hmm. So you got a new single coming out now?
I do. It's called Problems.
And what's Problems about? Problems.
So I kind of just took a reference from the Jay-Z 99 Problems song.
Yeah.
And I flipped it into something more current and my vibe.
And when is that dropping?
Actually, it was supposed to drop on 314 day. Mm-hmm. But now I'm about to actually reshoot the video at Club Banga March 29th.
Why?
Make it more. It's going to be actually official. We shooting it at the club. I got more people involved. Bringing out hella.
Wait. Okay, so let's go back. Let's talk about actually the video that you have for it now. So where did that idea of how, if you ever watched it, like, it's got a booty shake.
Okay, so how that kind of happened was, we literally just had the song. Then I talked to the videographer, Boomin.
Mm-hmm.
And he was like, yeah, okay, I'll shoot your video. This is a Friday. I'm like, when are you free? Like, my only available day is Monday for the next 2 weeks. I'm like, fuck, it's only 2 days. All right, well, come on, let's shoot the video. So I was just driving around. I was going to pick up some alcohol, so I was just driving around here like, dang, what am I going to do for a video? I got 2 days to figure it out. And I drove past a swimming pool complex.
Wow.
I'm like, bro, I'm about to do the video here.
And it was super, I want to say it was basic, but like, it was super easy, like, women coming, swimsuit, party. Like,
everybody was drunk, everybody was lit. We had somebody barbecuing on the
grill. Yeah, I had Ciroc in there too. Pour Ciroc.
It was kind of lit.
Yeah.
But now, we're going to actually make it more official. We got two clubs where we decide on where we're going to shoot it at now. Mm-hmm. But it's going to be March 29th. We got Cam J, he's going to come DJ it.
Oh, shoot. Y'all going to be lit.
Some of the legends are going to be out. We're going to kind of turn this mug up.
Yeah. So you got this event coming up for 314 day. Actually, you got two events coming up for 314 day. So the pre-party at Blue.
I do. That's going to be my unofficial, official single release for Problems. But I'm also going to do a performance for Club Bank. You know, I got to keep that wave going.
Mm-hmm.
But then I got a performance the following day at the Marquee. It's Andre's birthday, the owner of the Marquee.
Uh-huh.
So, yeah, we're going to turn it up.
Okay. Okay. So, you got a lot of stuff going on right now. Now, before you had the Trap Etiquette fashion show, so you kind of like dipping into fashion, music, promoting, hosting. But what got you into wanting to do like a fashion show?
All right. So, Prince Cartier, I don't know if you know him. He's mm-hmm. actually part of my creative team. So, he's like my creative director. Mm-hmm. So, he's been helpful throughout the years with everything I do for music. He keep me on shows. So, I told him, as long as he keep being supportive, I'm going to do whatever I can to help him. I had the opportunity in November to host my own fashion show with my connection with the Marquee. So, I'm like, hey, let's do it. So, we put it together. I already had a Trap Etiquette brand, which basically was highlighting the stars of St. Louis, mm-hmm. bringing energy to the city. So, I decided to call the fashion show Trap Opulence, which is like high-end fashion, but still a fashion.
Okay, so Trap Opulence was the fashion show, but Trap Etiquette is the
party brand.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay. So, do you plan on having any more in the future? Was it like a one-time thing?
Nah, I'm going to have some more. It's just like I'm trying to step and do everything first to see what I can do, and then I'm just going to line everything up and just
get you going. Yeah. Now, what makes you different? So now that you're an artist, you're a rapper now.
You know what I'm saying?
What makes you different compared to all these other St. Louis artists?
So I spent years like studying like the behind the scenes of it, like the business of it, and like actually trying to make music that's appealing to audiences. Mm-hmm. So it's like I'm not actually just trying to record song after song after song like most artists. I'm literally trying to make the hits and get the bangers out the way. So it's like my difference is I'm also me, so I don't care what nobody gonna say. I'm just gonna do what
it's
I
like
feel,
real
how I feel.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So how and why is it important to have different connections just in St. Louis, but also like you said, you know a lot of people in different states mm-hmm. that play your music. Like, how important is that in the music industry?
It's very important. If I'm just going to travel to a city with my family or friends on just a random vacation, I can just tap in with people. Mm-hmm. I can go get access in clubs. I can get access to different concerts. I always know like what's going on. So I'm always tapped with the end. But then now that I'm doing music, it's like I got access to actually get it to people that need to hear my music.
Yeah, definitely.
So it's not like I'm starting at ground zero.
Mm-hmm. Because you got the advantage of being, you were already a promoter, and that's already made like a name for yourself. Mm-hmm. Now it's like, we mess with Gusto.
Know what I mean? So now it's like, oh, wait, now you rap too? Okay, let me hear this. And then when it's actually good, they're like, okay, yeah, I can definitely support this.
Okay, so when you perform, though, I know you hosted, but does it feel different when you're actually performing your song?
At first it was kind of weird, but then it's like, no, I'm just naturally like that. Because I also play football, so it's like, I've been performing in front of crowds. I've been playing sports. I've been in front of a lot of people.
Yeah.
So it's like, nah.
But I say that, though, like, I've never seen you really host. So I've seen, like, on social media, you know, you're doing your mm-hmm. thing. But I've never seen, like, your energy. So I'm just curious as to...
It's just like, I'm smooth. I'm quiet, but I'm hella smooth. And I can always create a good vibe.
But that's what I'm saying. Like, when you start rapping, I'm like, you be joking.
I mean, because the songs I be making be turned up. It's like Club
Banga. Nah, Jonesboy be helping you. That's what it is. He be like leveling it out. Yeah. Okay, what's next for you?
So I'm dropping a problem single just to put something out to let them know that I can actually rap to other than making like turned up club dancing music. But after that, I got another single called Cap that I'm going to release.
That's a club dancing? That's a twerking song?
Nah, it's like...
It's going to play at Onyx.
No, it's going to play everywhere. It's going to be like a TikTok favorite.
A TikTok favorite?
The kids going to love it. The like adults going to love it. Everybody going to love it.
I hate TikTok.
Yeah, it's because you can't dance.
That's facts. I can't dance. I have no rhythm, first of all.
TikTok is for the people that can groove. I can groove on some, you know what I'm saying, smooth stuff.
All right, Gusto Diddy. All right, let everybody know they can find you and follow you. Listen to Club Banga.
Hey, you can stream Club Banga on anything that plays music. It could be Google Play. It could be Spotify. It could be Apple Music. You can go to iTunes if you want to. You can find me on Instagram at Gusto Diddy, GUSTO.DDY. Twitter, you can find me at Gusto_314. That's pretty much it.
All right. And I'm on the XL. Make sure you guys follow me at 94XL. Make sure you spell 90 out, 4XO. Search 94XL podcast. Subscribe. All of that. We out. Be easy.
It's your girl, Moni XO, and you just finished watching an episode of 94XO. Make sure you guys hit subscribe and follow me on social media.